Expatriate Taylor Swift. And it's the final day. Nick Simon just went to the St. Kilda Festival. And he saw Maxime Orr the other day. Yes, you heard it. Maxime Orr from Hinges and Collectors. A great Aussie band. And here we are at a Taylor Swift concert. Look what he posted. There's Taylor Swift and Taylor Day. A Taylor. And Jack sets it live with a wake up challenger photo, but what's this?
And she ground a finger into my breastbone. And she said,
Taylor Gray, another Taylor. We saw that yesterday. He flipped.
I'm a woman anymore.
Talking about Maxime Orr and the Underdog, or Hunters and Collectors. Let's talk about it to the Taylor Swift fans. Also known as the Swifties. Maxime Orr formed Hunters and Collectors in 1980 with a bunch of uni friends. The band became famous for its rhythmic power and very quickly became touted as the next big thing. The album In the Frailty was recorded in Melbourne in 1985. This record has proven to be one of the most important and enduring records of the 80s. And Hunters and Collectors were still playing a large part of this, cut in 1998 when they retired. As well as 13 Hunters and Collectors albums, Mark has released 7 solo albums and 3 with his current band, The Underdog. Throughout it all, he has shown he is one of our finest songwriters, capturing our stories of love, loss, wind and courage and achievement. Let's see what Rap Guy is doing.
Yes, Taylor Swift again. What's in the VIP again for Taylor Swift? Oh yeah, Taylor Dane. Mark Seymour, the Underdog, are also good. Mark Seymour. Yes, the front man of Hunters and Collectors, his brother, Nick Seymour, is in a more successful band, the bass guitarist of, you guess it, Crowded House.
See, Taylor Swift is popular. You know what he means. You get it, the Carina photo. Everybody should see this. Well, that's one way if anyone doesn't want to see Sabrina Carpenter.